Gozo Contemporary was founded by Norbert Francis Attard, a contemporary artist from the island of Malta who trained as an architect before focusing on a diverse art practice that incorporates architecture, sculpture, photography, video, and installation. He has exhibited internationally and has represented Malta at the 48th Venice Biennale in 1999. Norbert Francis Attard often works with physical sites, drawing on a broad range of interests from religion to science to explore the relationship between nature and technology, mankind and the environment. Norbert is now based in Gozo, a short 30-minute ferry ride from Malta. The island of Gozo is part of the Maltese archipelago. Gozo is 67 square kilometers in size, which is approximately the same size as Hong Kong Island, and has a population of about 32,000. Gozo Contemporary is situated in Arab, a quaint village located at the westernmost point of the island. Gozo Contemporary aims at introducing artists and organizations to the island of Gozo, a unique and creative environment that has inspired artists for over 7,000 years. Gozo Contemporary's mission is to develop Gozo as a meeting place for creative people from around the globe. This multifunctional space will host contemporary artists by providing a working and living space for the artists in residence. The Republic of Malta is a small and densely populated island nation, comprising of an archipelago of three main islands in the Mediterranean Sea: Malta, Gozo, and Comino. A southern European country, Malta lies south of Sicily, east of Tunisia, and north of Libya. The country's official languages are Maltese and English. Roman Catholicism is the most practiced religion. The islands constituting the Maltese nation have been ruled by various powers and fought over for centuries. Malta has been a member state of the European Union since 2003 and is currently the smallest EU country both in population and area. Malta's strategic location at the crossroads of the Mediterranean shipping lanes has always played a crucial role in the island's history. Over the centuries, the great Mediterranean powers have fought to dominate the islands, each new arrival leaving its legacy. What we see today is a complex amalgam of ethnic influences. The Arabs introduced citrus trees and flat-topped houses, and they laid the foundations for the Maltese language. The Aragonese from central Spain left their mark in the medieval architecture of Malta's historic town centres, and the enclosed wooden balconies which typify the splendid townhouses. Under the 268-year rule of the Knights of St. John, Malta blossomed into a major cultural center. The buildings they constructed touched on almost every sphere of human activity, from water distribution to heavy fortifications. The words which most readily come to mind in characterizing Maltese architecture are religion, defense, and limestone. The Maltese prehistoric temples, particularly the temples of Imnidra and Hajar Im, were built around 3500 BC. The architecture of these temples is beautiful and inspiring, their scale impressive yet human. These magnificent freestanding stone structures are older than both Stonehenge in England and the pyramids in Egypt. While Neolithic people left their mark in the mighty temples to their gods, the long, continuous Christian tradition has given rise to huge and ever more splendid edifices to the glory of God. The island's defences are equally eloquent, as can be seen in the sighting of Arab Imdina or the fortifications of Aragonese Birgu, now Vittoriosa, or in the obsessive and interminable military buildings of the knights. The churches of Malta and Gozo are primarily Baroque in style. Splendid domes are a hallmark of Maltese churches, their huge dimensions dwarfing the surrounding village houses.